exotic cuisines, high fashion, top celebrities, glamorous events, and much more. Lunchtime will never be the same again, and that's a promise you can take to the bank. Crunch, the hottest lunchtime entertainment show on African television. Weekdays from 12 to 2 p.m., exclusive to Nigeezy. Extremely Nigerian.
Pretty amazing, nice.
Thank you.
So why did you choose the whole denim jean thing?
Well, that's me. Like, because it's an interview, I have to go with some heels. Yeah, and then the jeans. And I think the blazer just to make me look more, you know, professional. Beautiful. On screen.
Okay, now Juliet, first and foremost, let's get to meet you. Who is Juliet Ibrahim? How would you describe yourself in just one sentence?
Juliet Ibrahim is a no-nonsense person. Well, that's if I have to just describe my personality, but I'm determined. So if you put it, a no-nonsense person who's very determined and knows what she wants, that's who Juliet is.
Okay, beautiful. Yeah. Now, your sojourn into Nigerian entertainment, the journey into being a celebrity, how did it all start?
I think ever since I was born to be a celebrity. I was like a lucky baby. Like my mom had me when she was still like she just graduated, sort of, and she fell in love. You know how it was, like you meet some guy and then you just fall in love and then you get pregnant and then you get married.
Wow.
And you just love this child, and you know, so that's like, okay, a star baby is born in the family. And I grew up, even though my growing up was a bit rough because of war, like we had to experience war in different countries, like when growing up, Liberia, Lebanon, Ivory Coast.
Did you witness the war?
Yes, I did.
Ooh.
Yeah. I still had the family love, like my sisters, my brother, my mom and dad were always there, like there for us. And even when I wanted to watch an Indian movie and sing along to the Indian songs, they'll always be there, encourage me. Yeah, you're doing so well and stuff like that. I even learned how to start speaking Hindi on my own just from watching movies. It started from then. That's when I knew that I actually wanted to be on TV or like be seen or appreciated, you know.
How do you look at yourself in the aspect of humanity?
The two aunties of mine had kidney failures due to two different reasons. One had lupus and she fell out and it led to her kidney failing. And this one that had a lupus and now she lives with a kidney failure was the very first person that got me a job when I was looking for my very first job in her gym. And seeing that she was this strong person, energetic person, just happened to just break down, close down the gym and everything just because of a kidney failure. You have to pay for dialysis treatment 3 times a week and $100 a day. That's $100 a day. So it's hard, it's not easy, and that's what she's living on till date. She can't do a transplant because she's older, she's in her 50s. It's not everybody who can be lucky to get a transplant done and they survive. There's a whole lot of complications that comes with it. So most time they just live with the dialysis treatment forever until they're called.
Okay.
Yeah. And the other one got hers through diabetes. When you are diabetic, you are prone to getting a kidney failure because of some reason, somehow, your kidney is just going to fail and then you have to live with it. If you have high blood pressure, that's another thing too that causes kidney failure, you know. So when I found out, I was like, wow, these people are dear to me. I grew up with their kids. I call them aunties and this is happening to them. I mean, it can happen to any other older person out there or even young ones out there who do not know that if you have high blood pressure or diabetes and you can get a kidney disease or something, So why not start something? Because before then, I was just doing normal humanitarian work where I just help the young kids. I just go to the orphanages and just donate stuff, to them. But then, even though I still do that every now and then, I just help anybody that I feel like helping when I have.
Do you have this much money?
No, it's not for the money. Do you know that? Let me give you a story. There was this day I went to a hospital to visit a friend. And they brought this little girl in who fainted on the roadside, like a hawker, street hawker. And I just heard the doctor, the nurse complaining. She doesn't have money, like in Ghana, like she doesn't have money. She wants to be sleeping around. Now she's pregnant. She's there. She's fainting on the road and blah, blah, blah. So I was like, are you sure she's pregnant? How do you know? Like, she doesn't even have money for me to run tests on her. So let her be there. She's on drips. I was like, no, you don't do that. You know, how much is it going to cost to run a test on the girl? And she told me it's about maybe 2,000 naira or something for them to just draw her blood and run tests to know what exactly is wrong with the girl. But she assumed that it's pregnancy because she fainted on the roadside. So when I sat there and I made them to run the test, they came back and said the girl she's anemic. That's why she fainted. She's not pregnant. So this is somebody who is hawking on the street. She doesn't have much money to buy food for herself or even drugs. She doesn't know. But you could have brought her there, just give her drips and say, go, because you are pregnant. What if she's not pregnant? What if there's something else wrong with her? So sometimes the 1,000 naira, 2,000 naira you have can make a difference in someone's life. So it's not about how much I have. I don't have. I'm also working. I also need stuff for myself. I also need to save money for myself. But every time, at least there's something you have to give back to someone who is going to appreciate it. The blessing you get from that person can mean a whole lot to you that you won't even realize that it can make a difference in your life. Wow. There's a feeling you get when you do it. Trust me, that feeling is like I said, I don't have the chance to go to church every Sunday. But when I do something like that, I know that I've done something that is right in the eyes of God. Trust me, that's it. So the foundation I have, like right now, even though we are into kidney stuff, kidney, there's a three-year-old kid from Osun State here in Nigeria. We are trying to raise money for her eye cancer. She had eye cancer, and it spread to the brain. 3 years old, yeah. And she needs money, 5 million naira, for them to take her to India for surgery so that she can be okay. I could have just let it go and be like, oh, I'm only for kidney people. Yeah, but no, this is a baby. Like, it can happen to anybody, you know. So I was very touched and I was like, no, let me go out there. I came here about 2 weeks ago. I met with some people and I went out there. We're still running a campaign online for people to donate to her and for her family to be able to take her outside for surgery. So people can go to 234give.com and they can donate online for Moye. Her name is Moye. For her to get the eye surgery that she needs. But hopefully, before the year ends, at least she can be able to go through the surgery and be okay. And you know, because she's a kid too, you can't wait because it's cancer. Cancer spreads. Now it has gone to the brain, it can come to the bones and whatever. As long as it's still there, it can spread.
Chilet Ibrahim, a celebrity for this week's edition of Crunch. Remember, this is the best celebrity program on TV. Of course, you know how it is. Every week, we get to give you the gist, the vibe, the glitz, the glamour of different celebrities. Chilet, right here on set. I'm sure there's so much to achieve. There's still hurdles you'd cross.
Yeah.
Where do you see yourself in 3 years to come from now? Precisely 5 years from now, where do you see yourself?
Well, I always say this. I know I have a whole lot planned. Like you said, there's still things for me to do and places for me to go, but my target is to be listed among the top 10 most influential women in Africa on Forbes list.
Wow,
that's where I want to go, or that's the path I'm on. That's the only thing I can say now. So the rest of the things I'm going to do to get me there will come out.
Everything is still a gradual process, right?
Yeah.
Okay, people who love me, I want to see more of you. How did they reach you? I need to give out your Twitter handles, your Facebook handles, your Instagram handles, and all of that.
Okay. You can follow me on Twitter at Juliet Ibrahim. Simple. And on Instagram, Juliet Ibrahim. Simple. On Facebook, my fan page on Facebook is Juliet Ibrahim Safo Original Fan Page. It has original fan page. Every other Juliet Ibrahim is fake. I have about 15 fake Facebook accounts.
Are you serious?
Yeah. So mine is the one with Juliet Ibrahim Safo original fan page. I had to add the original just to make a difference. So I find people meeting me out there like, I've been chatting with you on Facebook, happy birthday. And my birthday is in March, not August or not July.
Okay.
So there are fake people on Facebook. On Twitter, it's just me, Juliet Ibrahim. I have like, I'm the only active one on there on Twitter.
Okay, yeah. Beautiful, beautiful.
Yeah, I'm always, every day I tweet. Every day I tweet.
Okay.
And on Instagram.
So you're a big fan of Twitter, right?
Yeah, Twitter and Instagram. I think Twitter is better. I'm not really a fan of Facebook anymore because what I tweet can go to Facebook.
Facebook, yeah.
When I put something on Facebook, it goes to Twitter. So I don't need to be going on only one. I just do that.
Way. Okay. Yeah. Now, away from the usual entertainment discussion, Juliet, you're on Crunch on Nigeria.
Yeah.
Where we get to host different celebrities on a weekly basis, on a daily basis as well. Now, what's your feel of the program? What can you say about this time out?
Well, I'm having fun. I'm having fun here, and it feels good to be invited by you guys. And definitely, I wouldn't mind coming again.
Wow, beautiful. But I guess we have to plan better for the next interview.
Sure. I wouldn't mind coming again. Maybe after my movie is out or something, and we can talk about it more. And maybe my next project, I have a reality TV show coming
wow.
up. Or maybe my music video. You get to play my music video for them.
You have a video as well.
It's not out yet. I'm about to shoot it. But I have a song out.
Yeah.
It's called Celebrate. Yeah. You know, I told you I wanted to be a musician.
You know, I know, but what would you be looking like in a music video?
Oh, hot. Nicki Minaj kind of
thing. Juliet Ibrahim.
Nicki Minaj kind of thing.
So is it going to be crazy? Are you going to be doing the crazy
Yeah,
crazy,
that's
crazy
what I'm thinking about. It's called Celebrate. So I'm going to be celebrating life. The song, actually, if you listen to it or if you download it online, it's on iTunes as well. I'm celebrating what God has done for me. I think you get to hear from my lyrics the kind of person I am, sort of. Because I'm just appreciating what God has done for me. And I'm telling everybody to join me. And just, you know, have fun. Yeah.
Beautiful. It's actually been a wonderful time out here, Juliet. Your last words to your fans and everyone who loves you.
To my fans, I love you guys so much. Thanks for the support. My Nigerian fans watching, I'll be back on this show, but just make sure you keep requesting. I will come right back. Thanks so much for all the questions. I hope I answered everything you guys asked. And follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, wherever. I'll try my best to keep in touch with you.
Beautiful. So, Juliet, this is Crunch on Nigeria. I need to tell Africans, tell Nigerians how much you love Crunch.
Hi, my name is Juliet Ibrahim, and you're watching Crunch on Nigeria. I love this show.
Okay, fair. On a daily basis, we get to unravel the mysteries behind the different facets of Nigerian entertainment. None of what we all know is critical. It cannot be left out when you talk about Nigerian entertainment. And of course, Juliet Ibrahim has contributed immensely. Now she's delved from being an actor, being a producer, into being a musician. That's really amazing, right? Okay, it's actually been very fantastic talking with Juliet Ibrahim. But before we come back and then take the closing part of the show, we'll go on another musical break. We're going to play you different sets of musical videos. I do hope you enjoy this musical video. When we're back, we'll get on the next segment on Crunch. Remember, it's Tuesday. It runs from 12 noon to 2 p.m. And today, we're up in the woods.
Yeah. Lunchtime just got a lot tastier, juicier, and sexier. Join Wofi on Crunch, the hottest lunchtime entertainment show in Africa.
I love Crunch.
I love Crunch.
I'm on Crunch.
I love Crunch.
Crunch, weekdays from 12 to 2 p.m. only on Nigeezy. Extremely Nigerian.